Tired of scattered tasks and endless lists? Get ready to visualize and organize your work like never before. I'll show you the power of visual task boards. You can access visual task board from the All menu and starting to type the name. You can see it under self-service. The first time you access the visual task board, you see a welcome screen. You can create a new board from here. As you can see, you can create either a freeform board or a data-driven board. We'll start by creating a data-driven board. Let's go for the incident table. I can choose a vertical lane and an optional horizontal lane, which we call swim lane. So let's go for a vertical lane of state and a swim lane of priority. This way, I can see incidents grouped by state and priority at the same time. At the next screen, I can define some filters. For example, I can say I'm only interested in active incidents. I can also add sorts. For example, I want my incidents to be listed based on creation date in descending order. Based on the filter you apply, you can see the number of cards that will be displayed on the board. Let's keep the active as true and create the visual task board. And here it is. As you can see, the vertical lanes show the state, so I can see new, in progress, on hold, resolved, closed, and canceled. Since I only chose active incidents, I don't see any cards under closed or canceled. And as swim lanes, I can see different priorities, starting with critical, high, moderate, low, and planning, which is the lowest priority. There's also a none option, which is not applied. The good thing is I can go to the swim lane menu and hide a lane that I'm not going to monitor. Before we get to the cards and see how they look like, I want to show you how the visual task board works. You can actually move the lanes. For example, I can grab a lane and move it to my desired position on the board. I can also set a lane limit. For example, I don't want to see more than 5 incidents on hold. So that could be a KPI for me. And I can see there is a warning since the total number of incidents on this lane is more than 5. So this could be a good indication of how many cards we have on this lane and what's our target. Same as swim lanes, I can go and hide vertical lanes. Apart from hiding a lane, you can also collapse them. For example, I can collapse the critical swim lane. I can go back and expand the swim lane whenever I need. On the top banner, there are a few things you can control. First of all, based on the table and the fields that you've selected before creating the board, you can see a default name created for this. In this case, incidents by state and priority. You can simply click on it and update the name. For example, active incidents by state and priority. You can see the type of the board written underneath. So this is a guided board. You can filter the cards by their title or number. For example, I can search for a keyword like access, and I can see all the cards that match my keyword based on their title. Let's clear the filter for now. The next menu is to show the cards based on their due date. If you've set due dates for your cards, you can easily filter them based on the few options, like the tasks that are overdue or they're due in a day, a week, a month or so. Next, you see the information icon, which allows you to see the basic information and the filters that you've set for this board. The star icon allows you to mark your board as favorite, so you can easily find it the next time. Then you can see the basic information, such as number of members or assignees, number of lanes, and number of tasks available on this board. You can see the structure of the board and change the settings if you like. You can edit the filter and sorting. And then you can share the link to the board with the members of the board. You can also see the list of all tasks in the board in a list view. Let's go back to the board. Then you can see the users menu. Here, you can see all the members and the task assignees in the board. You can easily promote an assignee to become a member. That way, they will have access to the board and can contribute directly. Alternatively, you can search for the members and add them to the board. Next, you can see the labels. You can toggle on the show labels and see the default labels available. You can add a label, change the color, and toggle it on. You can edit a label, and you can turn on or off some labels. Next, you can see the activity tree, and this shows all changes happening to the tasks on this board. And finally, the configuration. This menu allows you to show or hide certain things. For example, hide the names or show SLAs. There is also an advanced settings, which allows you to do further configurations on the board. For example, changing the background color or doing some lane configurations. Here, you can choose to show or hide a lane or simply reposition the lanes on the board. You can do the same on swim lanes. In the following videos, we'll look into using some of these functions and managing some tasks. Stay tuned!